الحمد لله الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقرارا به وتوحيدا وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما مزيدا أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعاذنا الله وإياكم منها أيها المسلمون اتقوا الله حق التقوى وراقبوا ربكم في السر والعلانية وفي النجوى All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, the most compassionate. We seek His help and we ask His forgiveness. And we bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, alone without associating any partners to Him. And we bear witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His prophet and messenger sent to mankind to guide them. And we bear witness that He has fulfilled the message and He has guided the Ummah and He has shown them the truth. Whoever stays on it, then he will be successful. And whoever goes astray, then he will be regretful. Furthermore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, O who you believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the best of fear, and do not die except as Muslims. And furthermore, the best speech is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His book, and the best guidance is the guidance of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And every newly invented matter in religion is an innovation. And every innovation is a misguidance. And every misguidance leads to the hellfire. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He protects us and you from the hellfire. My dear respected brothers and sisters, if you were to be asked the most important question in your life, if you were to be asked what is the greatest question in your whole life that you will be ever asked in this life of ours, what do you think it would be? And what is the answer to that question? The question is, my dear respected brothers and sisters, is why do we exist? And what is the reason of our existence? And the answer is found in the Quran by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most glorious, in His glorious Quran, where He says in Surah Al-Dariyat, Ayah 56, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship Me alone. And as the scholars of Tafsir say, يَعْبُدُونَ and worship here means as not to associate any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in worship. And that's why the scholars say, إِنَّ الْعِبَادَةَ لَا تُسَمَّ عِبَادَةً إِلَّا مَعَ التَّوْحِيدِ That worship is not called proper worship and it does not classify as proper worship except if Tawheed is associated and connected with it. Tawheed is monotheism of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worshipping Him alone and not to associate any partners with Him. And there are many evidences in the Quran that speak about this. And therefore, in order to understand this, in order to correct our tawheed, the person needs to understand the meaning of the word of tawheed, which is La ilaha illallah. And this word, my dear respected brothers and sisters, because of it, the whole dunya was created. To say La ilaha illallah, and to not worship anything but Allah, and to worship Him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like a merchant or a businessman, he is always finding and looking for the greatest business deal. And the greatest business deal for us with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala believers is this word, my dear respected brothers and sisters. To understand its meaning and to fulfill its condition. And the word La ilaha illallah has two pillars, as the scholars told us. The first pillar, we call it affirmation, which is to affirm and to confirm something. And the second pillar for this, it is negation, which is to cancel out or to negate something. When you say La ilaha, you negate and you cancel out and you say that there is no God, or there is no true deity, or there is no true Lord that should be worshipped. Illallah, except Allah, in truth. And this is the affirmation part, where you affirm and you confirm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only true God, and the only true deity, and the only true Lord. And all the other things and deities that are worshipped beside Allah are false. And that's why we say La ilaha illallah. It means La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah, that there is no true deity or God or Lord worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, in order to fully understand this, the word La ilaha illallah, as the scholars, may Allah have mercy on them, made it easy for us by breaking it down for us. And they said that La ilaha illallah has conditions to assist us and to help us in understanding. And we find these conditions in different wordings in the hadith of the Prophet and in the Quran. And we look at these conditions and we classify them as teeth for a key. Because we all know, if we have heard before, that as it came in a hadith of the Prophet in the explanation of the companions, that La ilaha illallah is like a key to Jannah. And one of the great scholars of the past, rahimahullah, Wahb ibn Munabbih, when he was asked, they said to him, isn't the word La ilaha illallah a key to Jannah? He said, yes it is. But isn't every key has its teeth? And these conditions that we're going to mention today are the teeth for the word La ilaha illallah. And every Muslim needs to understand them and to have them with him. And if he fulfills them, then his life will be fulfilled. And he has fulfilled the deal that he has made with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is where we worship nothing but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took a deal and made a deal, or agreement, or covenant with the sons of Adam, all of the humans, that nobody should be worshipped except him. And in order to fulfill this agreement, the person needs to understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah and its conditions that are attributed to it, so he can have successfulness in this dunya and in the akhirah. If we look at the hadith of Prophet Muhammad in regards to this matter, then they have many wordings. It was narrated, for example, that the Prophet said, "Man qala la ilaha illallah mukhlisan biha." Whoever says La ilaha illallah with having sincerity in it, then something will happen to him, as the hadith will carry on, which we mentioned. It came in another narration that the Prophet said, "Man qala la ilaha illallah mustayqinan biha qalba." Whoever says La ilaha illallah with affirmation and having affirmity and with La ilaha illallah, and to have sincerity with La ilaha illallah. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man qala La ilaha illallah yaquluha haqqan min qalbi." Whoever says La ilaha illallah and he says it with truthfulness in his heart or from his heart, then the rest of the hadith carries on. So we find that in the sunnah of the Prophet wasallam, and in the athar that came after him from his companions, and the generations, the pure generations after that, we see that the Prophet wasallam and his companion show us these conditions for La ilaha illallah. And it is a must for the Muslim to know these conditions. Because the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he says in the Quran, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Know that there is no true deity or Lord in truth except Allah. And therefore knowledge is the most important thing from these pillars that we will mention. And these pillars, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the scholars have mentioned them in 7 points. And therefore, to make it easy for the Muslim to understand them and to memorize them. Simple, very easy points. They are, in quickly before we go to them in detail, they are ilm, to have ilm and knowledge with La Ilaha Illallah. To have yaqeen and certainty with La Ilaha Illallah. To have iqiyad and to comply with La Ilaha Illallah. To have qubool and to accept La Ilaha Illallah. To have truthfulness in La Ilaha Illallah, which is sidd. And to have mahabba in La Ilaha Illallah, which is love. And to have ikhlas and sincerity with La Ilaha Illallah. 7 made very easy, which we will explain, my dear respected brothers and sisters. In order for a person to fulfill these 7 conditions and to understand them, the scholars say that the doors of Jannah would be open for a person, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would bless a person for having the understanding of La Ilaha Illallah. And it's not only good to have the understanding or the knowledge of these matters, but rather to act by them and to understand their full meaning. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make those who say the correct speech and the affirmed speech, which is La Ilaha Illallah, He will make them firm and steadfast in this dunya and in the akhirah. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من قال لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله مستيقنا بها قلبه أو مؤمنا بها. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله, believing in it completely. And this belief has to be followed by an action. It has to be followed by action. It's not only belief. It is not okay to have belief alone, but rather actions have to be followed with it. And if a person does that as it came, in one of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ narrated in Sahih Bukhari, then the person will be entered Jannah. And therefore, this is a beautiful, glad tidings from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, as was mentioned from the authority of the companion Ubadah ibn Salam, as what came in the Musnad of Imam Muslim, in Sahih Muslim, where the Prophet ﷺ says, من قال لا إله إلا الله حرم الله عليه النار. Whoever says لا إله إلا الله, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him from the hellfire, and he will make the hellfire haram for him. So hellfire will not come near him and it won't touch him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us a tawbah. But in order for that to happen, we have to understand it fully. And especially in our time, which is full with trials and tribulation and tests, and going away from the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and going away from the teachings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear respected brothers, it's the time now to go back to the Quran and the sunnah, to understand it, and to understand these basic principles of the religion. The religion is based upon these principles. Therefore, the Muslim has to understand them, and we have to teach them to our children, and we have to spread this around so we can understand it and fulfill it. And also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as what came in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, also from the hadith of Ibadah ibn Salih, من قال أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله وأن عيسى عبد الله وابن أمته وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه وأن الجنة حق وأن النار حق أدخله الله الجنة من أي أبواب الجنة الثمانية شاء. That whoever says and testifies and believes that there is no true God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger, and that Isa alayhi salam is his servant and messenger, and also a child of Maryam, which is a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his slave, and also Isa is a speech that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a command that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put in the womb of Mary, or Maryam alayhi salam. And also, if he believes that the hellfire and or Jannah isn't truth, and hellfire is truth, then he will be entered from the 8 gates of Jannah, whichever he likes. Look at this greatness, my dear brothers and sisters. But in order for all of this to happen, from what we mentioned, the person has to testify and believe and act upon these things. So therefore we say, the first from these great pillars, or conditions actually, that are given to us in order for us to understand, La ilaha illallah is ilm. To have knowledge with the word La ilaha illallah. And knowledge is obviously different to ignorance and not having knowledge. And the evidence for this pillar or condition is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Know, O Muhammad, and every single believer, that there is no deity or God worthy of worship in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Knowledge has to be attained to this. And we have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only true God. And that there is no ma'bud or no worshipped thing in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And everything else beside him is false and wrong. And as it came in the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as narrated in the Sahih Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من مات وهو يعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whoever dies and he knows and he has knowledge that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he's entered Jannah. This is the first condition, to have knowledge of La ilaha illallah. As for the second condition, it is to have yaqeen, certainty with La ilaha illallah. And it is to have certainty with the word itself, La ilaha illallah, and the statement. And to have certainty with its meaning, and to follow this certainty with action. And not to have doubts about La ilaha illallah, but rather to be certain about La ilaha illallah. A certainty that is 100%, as we could say. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the believers, إنما المؤمنون الذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ثم لم يرتابوا وجاهدوا بأموالهم وأنفسهم في سبيل الله أولئك هم الصادقون. Those are the believers. Who are they? They're the ones who believe in Allah and His Messenger, and they did not have doubts, and they did not have doubts in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they strive and struggle for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they make jihad with their wealth and themselves in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His path, and to raise His words. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الصَّادِقُونَ. They are the fully truthful ones. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about this matter, as was narrated in Sahih Muslim, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَنِّي مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Whoever says and whoever testifies that there is no true deity except Allah, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah, لَا يَلْقَى اللَّهُ بِهِمَا عَبْدٌ غَيْرَ شَاكٍ فِيهِمَا إِلَّا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. If he meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if a servant of us, of the believers, meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with believing in these and having certainty of these two things, and not to have doubt in them, then you will enter Jannah. From the third conditions that are given to us in order for us to understand La Ilaha Illallah, it is to have qubool and acceptance in La Ilaha Illallah. And what does that mean? It is to accept the word La Ilaha Illallah and everything that it contains with your heart fully, and to stay away from everything that La Ilaha Illallah teaches you to stay away from, like shirk and associating partners with Allah or anything that is similar to that. Therefore, that Tawheed, we see here that Tawheed is the base of La Ilaha Illallah, and that's where La Ilaha Illallah comes from, the reason for our creation. The person has to have qubul and acceptance with this matter, and he has to say it with his tongue, and he has to stay away from the disbelief and anything that connects the person to disbelief. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. Talking about the kuffar, talking about the hypocrites, when it is said to them, say La ilaha illallah, they used to become arrogant and they did not accept this word and this great statement. Therefore, acceptance and qubul is one of these great conditions. Also, from the conditions of La ilaha illallah, it is to have inqiyad, or comply, and to follow completely the meaning of La ilaha illallah and all of its actions. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُسَلِّمْ وَجْهَهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٍ فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى وَإِلَى اللَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And whoever upholds and surrenders himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and complies with everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has instructed him with, then he's a muhsin. He is a good person with good deeds. He's a true believer. And he has upheld and stayed with the agreement that we had with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he held it properly, and he did not let go. Then to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all the good ending. Therefore, a person has to accept the meaning of La ilaha illallah and to comply with these conditions and to fulfill the actions that are come with these conditions. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who fulfill these actions and to understand them, and to make us of those who say shahada on their last tongue and their last breath, so we can enter Jannah and we meet with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the truthful ones and the martyred ones. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Make istighfar to your Lord.